Howdy guys, Marty Scribner here at AMS Ducati Dallas, and today we also have Colby joining in on the video. He's going to be a reference point for a normal-sized human being. I am Marty Scribner, 30-inch inseam, 5'7". Colby is going to be 6 foot, 33-inch inseam. As a reference point, and the purpose of this video is going to be seat heights through the entire, well, mostly the entire lineup. And as you can see here as we pan, it's going to be kind of a longer video, so if you see one of those bikes you're interested in and you may be vertically challenged like me, you can just fast forward until you see that pop up in frame. So let's kick it off. We'll mention a bunch of stuff along the way. First seat height specimen is going to be the Scrambler 800. This is just over 31-inch seat height, pretty narrow seat. And as I get on, I'm wearing some Salomon hiking boots, so pretty close to some riding boots. Obviously easily flat-footed, not a big deal. Very easy to go 1 foot on the ground, lightweight, slim bike. Colby will get on this for us. You'll see what a 33-inch inseam looks like on that about 31.4-inch seat. Colby here, if you have a similar inseam, you may be worried about the rider triangle, the distance between peg and seat. Just want to make sure you're not cramped on the 800 Scramblers. We're going to jump to the tallest Scrambler next, obviously the Desert Sled. We don't have a Desert X here until Saturday, a couple days, so unfortunately we won't have the Desert X for you. Stay tuned for that. Obviously this will be the tallest, but it's also going to have 7.9 inches of travel on those front forks, and it's going to squat quite a bit since it's capable of off-road. So once again, I have a 30-inch inseam, 5'7", and you'll see that pretty much the toes, just the tippy toes of the boots reach the ground. Once again, lightweight, not a big deal. In fact, I can kind of keep my feet off the ground and be comfortable with it. If you're short like me, vertically challenged, I definitely recommend the one butt cheek off, one solid foot on the ground. You're gonna be a lot more stable in high winds or a slope. Let's see what 33 inches looks like from Colby on that Desert Sled. Much more obtainable to the ground, makes it look easy, and not a big deal for him to get those feet on the ground, especially in that rear shock squats. So kind of the motivation behind this video is, one, these bikes aren't going to be in the showrooms these days. It's going to be very hard for you to walk in, depending on your market, and see all these bikes at once, or one of these specimens that you're interested in. Right now, most bikes are being pre-ordered. We just happen to have some bikes come in that are pre-sold, so we're going to take the opportunity to show you these bikes, talk a little bit about seats and ergonomics, things like that. So we got done with the Scrambler line. Let's go to the lowest seat height in the house, which is the Diavel, just over 30 inches here. And 30.7 inches. And this is probably gonna be the last one you see where I easily go flat-footed immediately at home. Just super, super easy for me. And if you have a 30-inch inseam on the X Diavel, it could be a challenge with the feet forward pegs out of the crate. But with the Diavel 1260, it's not any sort of like cramp-worthy bike. Your hips and knees are gonna be fine. Colby, on the other hand, he's definitely gonna have a bend in the knee. And if you're his height or taller, once again, you're gonna start to kind of think about hips and knees. Make sure the relationship with knee and tank is gonna work out for you. Although the Diavel lacks the utility for long trips compared to the Multistrada, you wanna make sure you're comfortable because it's definitely a fun bike to cruise on and get longer miles on. The Monster is an interesting specimen for the fact that out of the crate, it's still maybe too tall for you if you're my height, 30-inch inseam. But it's so capable for not a lot of money to actually go down in seat height. So not only can you get a lower seat, but you can also, there's a really cool inexpensive lowering kit from Ducati, which we have in stock. So what you're seeing right here in front of us is 32 inches, and it's a slightly wider seat. It gives you more surface area when you're riding, when your feet are up. But I am almost flat-footed. Definitely balls of the feet. You'll definitely be able to catch it. if needed, and see what Colby looks like on this monster. He definitely would not need any sort of lowering kit or seat. And yeah, he makes it look easy. That's 33-inch inseam versus my 30 on the monster. Now, the Street Fighters and the Superbike. So these are pretty much gonna be right at 33 inches, 33 and a half. The Superbike's gonna be different, the fact that you're from waist high, you're gonna be leaning forward, and that's really gonna play with your, you know, mess with your mind a bit. So when I sit on this, wider seat, and I'm back at back to the toes. Still, obviously, Ducati always makes a well-balanced bike, so it's very deceiving, it's very doable, but I highly recommend, once again, the butt cheek off, one solid foot on the ground, and post up. Let Colby show you what 33 inches looks like on the Street Fighter. Pretty, say flat-footed? Good to go? Yeah. So, life is unfair, and Colby making it look easy. So obviously, Mr. Speed Racer here, you have that lean forward, like I said, it's gonna play with your head a little bit. Don't let that discourage you. It's pretty much the same as that Street Fighter. You can get a different seat for this, but you'll see me at a stoplight in the hot pit area before getting on the track. It's always 1 foot on the ground. So still very doable. See what Colby has to offer. So he's pretty much balls of the feet, heels are off the ground by, you know, half an inch to an inch. Super doable. And then the Multistrada obviously is gonna take up a lot of real estate visually. So this is the bike I own and ride, and I get a lot of phone calls, a lot of emails from all around asking how it's done. The Multistrada is gonna be 33.1 in the low position, but you can bring it up to the 33.9 position with the stock seat. Just from motorcycle accidents, sports growing up, I actually, even though I'm 30-inch inseam, I prefer it in the tall position, just for the hip and knee angle. Mind the panniers when you get on. You bring it up, you're gonna have a little bit more weight. And yeah, same story, different motorcycle. Tippy toes all the way. And I typically go with my left foot down, even though you're not supposed to, since that's the gear side. I just feel more comfortable that way. So this is in the low position once again. That's 33-inch inseam. And right as rain. Colby's pretty much flat-footed, would you say? Yeah. Yeah, just a little gap on the heels. So you gotta remember, on the Multistrada, most of these shipping to the United States already have the heated seat. So if you're gonna order the lowered seat for your Multistrada, make sure it's the heated lower seat, the correct part number. You can easily get that wrong on the website. So partner with your dealership, or just hop on over to AMSDucati.com and we can get you the right seat. And then for the tallest seat in the house, luckily it's a little slim, but the Hyper Motard SP. This bike used to be, in its prior model, would have been pretty much 35-inch seat height. We're just over 34 inches now on the stock seat. You can get a lower seat, but this is already pretty minimal cushion on the stock seat, so that low seat I would avoid. So as I come up, you'll see I cannot touch both feet at the same time. So this is definitely going to be one of those situations where you're going to pick up, right leg down. But it's just so lightweight, it's just so easy to keep this bike upright. I don't think you're going to have an issue. Just come at it with some confidence and won't be a big deal. Now Colby making it look easy. Still pretty darn tall at 33-inch inseam, so not necessarily not really at the balls of the feet, but he's got the toes down. So definitely a tall horse. So watch out for that one. But make sure and check us out at amsducati.com. We'll have these seats in stock. Supply is getting a little bit better, and obviously we order big from Ducati, so we'll have the either taller seats or lower seats available for you. And if you have any questions, feel free to reach out to us, Marty at advancedmotorsports.com. Really appreciate your time.